friends, hope you are doing well at your home. Myself, Vaibhav Srivastav, and welcome back to my channel, Vaibhav E-Learning Academy. Today, we are going to continue our topic, Simple Interest. This is our part number 3. In the previous video, we had solved some word problems regarding simple interest. I hope you have understood that problems. Today, we are also going to solve some word problems, but we are not going to find the simple interest and amount. We are going to find the principal value. Let us start with a question. So the first question given to us is, Mr. Damon invested a sum of money from March 2015 to March 2020 at the rate of 12% per annum. If the interest received is 1620, find the sum. It says that Mr. David has invested some amount of money. We do not know that amount of money, and that is the principal. As we know what is a principal, the amount which is borrowed or given is known as the principal amount. So, we do not know what is the amount invested by Mr. David. That is the principal amount. The interest is given to us. We are going to use the formula for the principal. Now, let us see how can we solve the problem. Starting with the solution. First of all, let us write what are the given quantities. Here, the time period given to us is March 2015 to March 2020. Time period is equal to 2015 to 2020. We have to find out the total time. So, find the total time, we will be subtracting the highest value from the lowest value. So, 2020 minus 2015, as this is the highest value, this is the lower value, we are going to minus, we are going to subtract them both. 20 minus 15, 2020 minus 2015, thus, time is equal to 5 years. Time is equal to 5 years. We are not given the principal value, but we are given the rate of interest. Rate of interest is denoted by R, but it can also be denoted by ROI to be more complex. So ROI means rate of interest. We are going to take it as R. Rate of interest is 12% per annum. This is our rate for interest. The interest received. Which interest are we talking about? As we have learned in the starting video for simple interest, the interest we are referring here is simple interest. Now, as we know our T value, that is time, R value, that is rate of interest, and SI value, that is our simple interest, we can substitute the formula P is equal to SI into 100 by R into T. What is our SI value? So, principal P is equal to SI into 100. Our SI, that is simple interest, is 1620. Into 100 by R into T. R is 12% and T is 5 years. By 12 into 5. 1620 into 100 is equal to 162000 by 12 into 5 is equal to 60. This 0 and this 0 gets cancelled out. Let us try to solve them both to 3 table. 3 times 2 is 6, 3 times 5 is 15, balance 1, that becomes 12. 3 times 4 is equal to 12, and these two zeros. And now, 2 times 1, 2 times 2 is 4, balance 1 and 4. 2 times 7 is 14, and then these both zeros is equal to 2700. So, the principal amount Mr. David invested is ₹2700. Alright, this was our answer. But what if you have to check whether this answer is correct? Like you, I got the answer that the principal value is 2700. But how can we be so sure that it is 2700? Actually, the answer is the principal value. But if you want to check it, what we are going to do is we will be taking our SI formula. Simple interest is equal to principal into rate into time by 100. And then we are going to hide our simple interest. Our principal value will be this one. Our rate is given, our time period is given. So let us check how can we do that. SI is equal to P into R into T by 100. P is, principal is 2700. Rate of interest is 12%. Time period is 5 years by 100. Now let us sort out. 5 times 1, 5 times 20, 2 times 6, 2 times 10, 2 times 5, 2 times 3, 5 times 1, 5 times 5 is 25, balance 2 and 0 is equal to 4. 0 is equal to 540 into 3, 0 3's are 0, 3 4's are 12, balance 1, 3 5's are 15 plus 1, 16. Simple interest is equal to ₹1620. Alright, this is 1620, that was our interest here. So, what we did was, we hit our simple interest value, that was this interest value. We know the R, rate of interest, we know the T and we know the P. Principal P. We know all these values, then we substituted in this formula, we did all those multiplication and we got the simple interest. This is actually just for checking purpose, so we don't need to concentrate on this one much more. So, what we have to notice here is our main answer, that is the principal. Our principal is equal to ₹2700 and that's it. So, let us take one more question to figure out whether we can solve that one or not. Let us see. Alright, now we are here with another word problem. If a farmer paid 2025 rupees as interest over 3 years at 2% per annum to a money lender, how much loan had the farmer taken? Here we are given the time period, that is 3 years. We have given the ROI, that is the rate of interest, 2%, and we are given the simple interest, that is 2025. We have to find out the principal value. As the previous word problem, we are going to do the same. Let us see now how we can solve it. Given, first we have time, that is 3 years. And then we have rate percent. And then we have the simple interest. As 2025 rupees. We have to find out the principal amount. Principal P is equal to SI into 100 by rate of interest into time. Simple interest into 100 by rate of interest into time. The simple interest here is rupees 2025 is equal to 2025 into 100 by rate is 2%, time is 3 years. Is equal to 2025 by 6. Let's cancel out with 3 table. 3 times 2 is 6. 3 times 6 is 18. Balance 3. 18 balance 2. 22, 7. Balance 1. 1 and 5, 15. 3 times 5. Then these 2 zeros. And then by 2 table. 2 times 1. 2 3s are 6. 2 3s are 6. Balance 1 and 5. 2 7s are 14. Balance 1 and 0. 2 5s are 10. 0. 3 3 7 5 0. That is it. This is our answer. So if we write in our answer step, thus the farmer has taken a loan of rupees 33,750 rupees. This is our answer. Let us just quickly review what we have did here. Given time is equal to 3 years, rate is 2%, simple interest 2025. The formula is percentage P is equal to SI into 100 by R into T. We simplified that answer and then we cancelled out all those values. We got 33,750. You can also check this. You can check this answer with the key which was given in the previous problem. So this was the last video about simple interest. In the next video, we are gonna learn about compound interest. Basics of compound interest, introduction to compound interest and some formulas. So these are some the simple word problems which I have given. You can change the numerical value, change the characters and you can solve other problems. And if you have any doubt, be sure to comment me. I hope you have understood this video. Please like this video, share and subscribe my channel. Press the bell icon to stay tuned. Thank you and goodbye.